Welcome to another video on C programming language. In this video, we will talk about the language that the computer speaks, and also we will talk about the compilation and interpretation methods. Now, in the previous video, we have seen that the programmer will use a programming language and provide instructions to the computer, which we call as program, and according to these instructions, the computer will work. Now the question is, what language does the computer speak? Computers speak the language of zeros and ones. All electronics speak the language of zeros and ones. For us, this may look like a bunch of zeros and ones, but for a computer, this is a valid instruction. Now this language of zeros and ones is called as the binary language, because there are only two possible values, 0 or 1, hence the name binary language. Now the next thing is, if the computers understand only the binary language, are we going to write the program in zeros and ones? The answer is no. If we have to write the programs in only a sequence of zeros and ones, something like this, then it will be extremely difficult for us to write the instructions. We write the instructions or programs which are close to human-readable format. For example, this is a C program which asks the user to enter his name, and then it displays hello and the name that the user entered. Now, as a beginner, you may not understand this particular program. But as a beginner also, if you look at this code, you can understand certain things. For example, you can see something called as name here, and then you can see printf. You may think of it like print in a formatted way. And then you can recognize these messages like enter name, hello. And then you can see this scanf, which stands for scan the formatted string. So the code that we are going to write will be something like this, in a language which is very close to human-readable format. And now we know that computers don't understand this language. Computers only understand zeros and ones. So how this will work? Now this particular video is about the C programming language. So let us assume that now we have the program written in the C programming language, for example, which looks something like this. We call this code as the source code. Now this program can be in any other programming language. For example, maybe it can be in Python, or maybe it can be in Java, or it can be in C sharp. All these languages are close to human-readable form and computers don't understand them. So what we have to do is, we have to use a translator and we have to translate the code which is close to human-readable format to machine language or binary language which the computer understands. Now, what is this translator? This translator is another program which will take the source code in a particular programming language and it will convert that to another language. In this case, it will take the source code which is written in C programming language and it will convert that to machine code. Now, this usually can be done by using two different methods. One is called as the compilation method and second one is called as the interpretation method. Now, we will not discuss everything about these two methods in detail, but both of these will take the source code in one language and they will convert it to another language. When we use the compilation method, a program called as the compiler will take the source code, it will read the entire source code, it will read the entire file, and then it will convert all the code to machine code, and then that machine code is executed in the computer. Now, in this interpretation method, a program is called as interpreter is used. It reads the source code line by line, it converts them and then executes them. When we use the compilation method, entire source code is converted to machine code, and then that machine code is executed. When we use the interpretation method, the program called as interpreter goes through the source code. It reads one particular line of instruction. It converts that to machine code, and then that is executed. Then again, it comes back, reads the next line, converts that, then it is executed. Now, in some other video, we will talk about these two methods in detail. Now, for the C programming language, the compilation method is used. All the instructions is converted to machine code, and then that is executed. Now, if we think about what we have to do, we have to write the instructions in C programming language. Then we have to use a program called as compiler to convert or translate the code from C programming language to machine language or the binary language, and then that is executed. Now, in order to write the instructions in C programming language, we can use any text editor. In this example, you are seeing the Visual Studio Code text editor. We can use Notepad or any existing text editor, and we can write the instruction in C programming language. But in order to execute those instructions on the computer, we need the translator program or the compiler, which is capable of converting the C programming code to machine code. Now, if we just think about the C programming language, then it is just a specification. The compiler or the translator program is actually the implementation of the C programming language. If it is confusing, don't worry. When you learn more about this, everything will be clear. Just understand that we can write the C program using any text editor, but in order to run the C program, in order to execute the instructions written in C programming language, we need the translator program called as a compiler. So this is it, guys, for this particular video. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you have anything to say, write that in the comment box. For more tutorials like this, subscribe to the channel.